Hi guys, this is Aegis, and this is the anti-spoiler game between MBN and XPN. Of course, if you haven't watched those matches, those are quite good at times, so please go check those out. I have the links below. So this is actually me playing on ladder against some Zerg player. So P-Funk is my opponent here. He is the blue Zerg player. This is Slag Pits. So it's not actually a map that we have in the American Pro League, but possibly in the future we'll get some feedback from some top players about that. We'll see how it goes. And there's me throwing down my first pylon, and I will be telling you that I am going Blink Stalker in this game, and against the Zerg opponent who does decide to go a hatch first, I believe. I can't quite remember as of the moment, but we'll see what he decides to do in just a few seconds. There's my pylon coming up and a chrono boost going down on the probes. As usual, I really like to spend all of my chrono boost on my probes unless I do something like this Blink Stalker build, which I will save I think 3 chrono boosts to use on the Blink upgrade. Of course, I don't know if that's actually the best way of going about it, and there's me forgetting to make probes. And here we have a P-Funk now getting 3 additional drones, possibly gonna be going for that expansion. No, it looks like he's going for the spawning pool first, and I'm gonna be scouting over here in the wrong direction yet again, and his overlord is finally making its way over there, and there I decide to change the direction of my probe once I see that overlord. We've got the gas coming up for me, and the gateway about halfway complete. P-Funk is going to be probably going for a hatch real soon. There's me scouting that there is no hatch, and they're gonna be checking in here to see what kind of zerglings, if there are any zerglings out already. And there's a spawning pool coming up, so I'm not that worried about zerglings yet, but my gateway is about finished, should be getting into that gas. There's the probes getting into the gas, and also a cybernetics core. Usually I would like to have a probe out here already, but finally my probe makes its way over there. Gonna throw down that cybernetics core, and I also do scout that he's going for that hatch. There's a queen on the way for P-Funk, and he's gonna make a few mistakes that do cost him this game. And there's more probes coming out for me. So basically, it's going to be a really basic Blink Stalker build. As soon as this comes up, I throw down my Twilight Council, and then 2 more gateways. After I finish the Blink upgrade, all of my chrono boost gets spent on my gateways, and I get out those really fast Stalkers, try to do some damage, possibly take down an expansion. I can't really remember what the result of this game was. I didn't play it recently, it was a few days ago. There's the Warp Gate research coming up, and my Twilight Council now on the way. And I think I begin saving up the Chrono Boost right now. I'm gonna throw some onto that Warp Gate research since it takes so long. I have a probe kind of hiding over here. I'm trying to decide where to put that pylon. I think I decide to put it like somewhere over here. Don't quite remember, but there's the second gateway on the way, chrono boost on the cybernetics core. Continuing to make probes. I don't know if this is actually the best way to go about this build, but I really like continuing to make probes at all times. And there's the blink research on the way. My first stalker is still on its way, and there should be a third gateway real soon. But there is a pylon to prevent me and myself from getting pylon blocked. Oh yeah, I guess I decide to throw it down up here. I didn't know there was an overlord over there, and the Zerg player should soon be trying to scout my expansion to see if I have an expansion on the way, and if I don't, he should be really worried about an attack. And we're gonna see him continuing to make drones, which would be his mistake, which cost him the game basically, because as of this point, he should be technically ahead. He's getting 5 more drones right now, and here's the point where he should be scouting my expansion at the 6-minute mark, seeing that there's nothing there, and that he needs to ramp up on those units. He does get these larvae out, but we're going to see him turn all of those into drones in just a second. He has a bunch of larvae in his main as well. There's 3 additional drones being added. There's 4 being added over there. He could have gotten a couple of roaches right now. He's got a couple of larvae saved up as well. There's my first warp-in of stalkers. My blink upgrade is finished as well. I'm racking up a lot of minerals. And there goes down my proxy pylon. I do need to get a closer one, so there's another warp in, and then I move down the ramp. The Zealot does kill off that Zergling, so the Zergling, I don't know if it got the best information, but as of this point, he needs to start making those roaches. All of these larvae need to be made into roaches, like, right away, but he's not doing it. Instead, he's teching a little bit. He's getting the pneumatized carapace for his overlords to get that speed. He's getting a Hydralisk Den. Now 6 roaches on the way. He still has this larva saved up over here. That's a lot of roaches. That could be 13 roaches now on the way, and I'm moved over here. I've got my second pylon in. There's my other round of warped in stalkers, and I should be throwing the chrono boost on the gateways. Yeah, there's the chrono boost on the gateways, and we're gonna warp in a couple more stalkers, and there's his first roaches out on the field. Burrow is on the way. His queen does have extra energy, so he could have gotten an extra vomit down there sometime along the way. And there's the Blink Micro, gonna make sure that I keep every single stalker alive. I think I do lose a couple every once in a while. Yeah, there's one going down, but the roach count is just not high enough because he did not scout that natural expansion to notice that I did not go for any sort of expansion. And there's trying to get out more roaches. Zerglings on the way as well. There's a queen going down over here. The roaches now popping out, sort of just kind of running into this wall of stalkers. It's just not going to be enough. And I'm pretty sure I win this game. I've got my 2 injured stalkers over here that did get blink micro. I decide to blink those guys back just in case they get surrounded by any sort of drone zergling attack. And there's the burrow now finishing up. The roaches now popping out in the main as well. More roaches coming out over here. Gonna try to clean up these stalkers, but it's just not quite enough. And there goes down the hatchery. I think I might. Oh, I blink out of there. Where'd you get that money for so many stalkers with no expo? Of course I don't have an expo. You didn't scout my expo. So there's the roaches trying to clean this up, and I did not successfully blink micro that. And it looks like the stalkers will win this battle. More of stalkers reinforcing over here. Here's that one stalker over here. I'm trying to click on him. He's got 2 kills. He's been injured for the entire time, and he leaves the game. So, and I didn't actually spend all of my money. I guess I did not spend the chrono boost. Yeah, there's 50 chrono boosts left over here, and didn't get that production cycle down, I guess. I did get a production cycle. Maybe that extra probe making did delay my push, and possibly would allow me to expand under normal circumstances. So there's your anti-spoiler video, and if you're a new Zerg player, that's what I mean by you gotta scout your opponent every once in a while, make sure he's not doing anything crazy. So if you take a look at his vision, P-Funk, he doesn't actually know anything about my base. He has seen my gateway and my cybernetics core, and he knows nothing. And he's sort of like gathering his overlords, trying to do his own thing, which is good. He does have his Hydralisk Den ready to do that drop. But against aggressive builds, I guess it just doesn't hold up. And hopefully you enjoy what you see here. Please do subscribe.